Your Excellency President Thabo Mbeki, Chair of the AUHIB, President Abdeslam Aboubakr, the Representative of the Secretary General of the United Nations, Haile Mariam, and the Representative of the IGAD and the Syrian Government, Ambassador Lisan Johannes. Observers, the Leader of the Sudan Government Delegation, Ibrahim Gandour, members of the two delegations, ladies and gentlemen of the press and media, on behalf of the SPLM North delegation, it is leadership and rank and file, let me express our deep appreciation to the effort exerted by the AUHIB and the African Union, the United Nations, the IGAD, the United States and the European Union, and the two Ethiopian Prime Ministers, late Prime Minister Meles Zenawi and Prime Minister Haile Mariam Desalegn, for your tireless work to reconvene these talks after almost 2 years since the Sudan government denounced the Addis Ababa Framework Agreement. The SPLM North delegation is here today ready and prepared to reach a just and honorable comprehensive peace settlement in accordance with UN Security Council Resolution 246 and the subsequent AU communiques and resolutions, and on the basis of the June 28, 2011 agreement. And in the first place, to address the humanitarian crisis that is putting 1 million lives at risk. Many have already lost their lives and their dear ones. Straight away, we would like to express our readiness to negotiate an agreement on humanitarian cessation of hostilities that will stop the hostilities, open the access to deliver humanitarian assistance to the affected civilian populations in accordance with the international standards. And it will be equally add value to put an effective buffer zone between the Republic of Sudan and the Republic of South Sudan. Aware of the fact that the SPLM North is controlling more than 40% of the international border of the Republic of Sudan with the Republic of South Sudan, the SPLM North is positive and ready to cooperate for a solid demilitarized zone. The SPLM North will expect, by starting this negotiation, that the government of Sudan will release more than 600 political detainees, among them many women, ladies from the two areas and Darfur. That will create a conducive environment for us to proceed ahead. Again, the SPLM North is looking forward to a fruitful negotiation that will resolve the following three issues. One, the humanitarian crisis. To agree on a national framework as came in the agreement of June 28, 2011, to provide for an inclusive constitutional process to address the historical question how Sudan is going to be governed, with the participation of all stakeholders, political parties, and civil societies organization in a national constitutional conference. Number three, to resolve and address the new political and security arrangement in South Kordofan, Nuba Mountain, and Blue Nile states. We see clearly that this negotiation represents a new historical opportunity to realize a just peace and a peaceful democratic change that will lead to building a strong new Sudanese state on the basis of equal citizenship. And we equally see that there is a great opportunity to end war all over Sudan, and in particular from Blue Nile to Darfur in the west, by adopting a wider historical approach, and moreover, to build a strategic relation between the two Sudans that will lead eventually to a union between two independent states. The two parties need to look seriously into this opportunity during this engagement. We are ready to start direct negotiation on the basis of what we mentioned earlier, and we appreciate your support and look, and we are looking forward to work together. Thank you.
Thanks.